In 1909, Debussy served on a wind performance jury. Stimulated by these experiences, he wrote two clarinet pieces for the audition of the contestants in 1910, the first Rhapsody and the Petite Pièce. The contestants did not perform well in sight reading the Rhapsody. Only one passed with flying colors and came out with first prize. The original meaning of the term Rhapsody implied the recitation of a passage from a larger work. Musically speaking, it was applied to a composition of no specific form. Debussy's Rhapsody, however, shows a certain formal design and introduces the clarinet as a singing instrument, displaying the virtuoso qualities. The clarinet appears as a lyrical voice in the dreamy opening, supported by harps. The agility of the clarinet is demonstrated in a quick section, designated scherzando, which leads to a return of the opening before the scherzando is resumed. Now here is Robert Marcellus, the principal clarinetist of the orchestra, followed by Pierre Boulez, for the first Rhapsody for clarinet and orchestra by Debussy. the Rhapsodie No. 1 for a clarinet and orchestra by Claude Debussy. Robert Marcellus was the soloist, and the Cleveland Orchestra was conducted by Pierre Boulez. Mr. Marcellus was born in Omaha, Nebraska on June 1, 1928. He began to study piano at the age of 4 and clarinet when he was 11. The following year, he began to study clarinet with Earl Handlin of the Minneapolis Symphony. When the family moved to Washington, D.C. in 1944, he began to study in New York with Daniel Donat, former principal clarinetist of the Cleveland Orchestra. Now Robert Marcellus has returned to center stage, where he accepts the applause of the members of the Cleveland Orchestra as well as of the audience. Following 3 years in the Air Force Band in Washington, Mr. Marcellus joined the National Symphony in 1949 and became principal clarinetist the following year. In 1953, he was appointed principal clarinetist of the Cleveland Orchestra. He has recorded the Mozart Clarinet Concerto in A Major with the orchestra and George Sell for Columbia and Epic. Once again, Robert Marcellus has returned, this time accompanied by Pierre Boulez, who asks the members of the orchestra to stand with them. Mr. Marcellus has headed the clarinet department of the Cleveland Institute of Music since 1959, and since the summer of 1968 has served as chairman of the Wind Chamber Music and director of larger wind ensembles at the Blossom Festival School. In 1909, Claude Debussy served on a wind performance jury. Stimulated by these experiences, he wrote two clarinet pieces for the audition of the contestants in 1910, one of which was the first Rhapsodie for clarinet and orchestra. The contestants did not perform well in sight reading the Rhapsodie. Only one passed with flying colors and came out with first prize. The original meaning of the term Rhapsodie implied the recitation of a passage from a larger work. Musically speaking, it was applied to a composition of no specific form. Debussy's Rhapsodie, however, showed a certain formal design and introduced the clarinet as a singing instrument. Now here is Robert Marcellus and the Cleveland Orchestra under Pierre Boulez and the first Rhapsodie by Debussy. That was the Rhapsodie No. 1 for clarinet and orchestra by Debussy. Robert Marcellus, the principal clarinetist of the orchestra, was the soloist, and the Cleveland Orchestra was conducted by Pierre Boulez. Mr. Marcellus was born in Omaha, Nebraska. In 1928, he began to study piano at the age of 4 and clarinet when he was 11. The following year, he began to study clarinet with Earl Handlin of the Minneapolis Symphony. When the family moved to Washington, D.C. in 1944, he began to study in New York with Daniel Bonnard, former principal clarinetist of the Cleveland Orchestra. Following 3 years in the Air Force Band in Washington, he joined the National Symphony in 1949 and became principal clarinetist the following year. In 1953, he was appointed principal clarinetist of the Cleveland Orchestra.